evokes a lot of passion in its construct and the issues around it. And key to a democratic society is the subject of elections and how electoral disputes are resolved. In resolving electoral disputes or disputes associated with the electoral process, some resort to violence. And among other things, your discussions here will be to ensure how recommendations can be highlighted on how to deal with this phenomenon. As you go through this discussion, I want to highlight a few things that I pray you to consider. First, in looking at the causes, one of the causes that I'd like to draw your attention to is a simple subject of suspicion. And Reverend Chair, with your permission, I'll tell you a little story. Ahead of the 2020 elections, a colleague from our side of the political divide told me a story about how his local constituency executives were so convinced that our opponents on the other side, or his opposing candidate on the other side, had essentially succeeded in gathering ballot papers and ammunition that was going to be used to undermine the electoral process, and were clearly convinced of seeing and urging him to take action on it. After having an opportunity to interrogate their suspicions and their questions a bit more, holding at bay his own people, they were able to find out that what they were dealing with was mere suspicion and nothing more. Colleagues who play in the political space here will bear testimony to the fact that one of the challenges, one of the things that leads to this exercise, is the high level of suspicion that we have among ourselves. My prayer is that as you go through your conversations, you factor this into your deliberations and examine how the levels of unwarranted suspicion are occasioned and how they can be kept as part of the exercises to find lasting solutions to this.